अस्सलाम वालेकुम, माई सेल्फ अहकाम अंसारी स्टूडेंट, आई एम बैक अगेन विथ येट अनदर वीडियो लेक्चर ऑफ इंफॉर्मेशन टेक्नोलॉजी। इन दिस पर्टिकुलर वीडियो लेक्चर वी विल लर्न अ प्रोग्राम और वी विल ट्राई टू सॉल्व अ प्रोग्राम गिवन बाय द जावास्क्रिप्ट। दिस प्रोग्राम इज वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट, दिस कैन बी कम इन योर एग्जामिनेशन बिकॉज इट्स गिवन इन योर टेक्स्ट बुक एंड इवन इट्स हैव सम इम्पोर्टेंट दैट दिस क्वेश्चन हैव बीन आस्क्ड इन एन नंबर ऑफ द टाइम इन योर बोर्ड एग्जामिनेशन। आई एम टॉकिंग अबाउट HSC board examination. So this question is common for HSC as well as for standard 11. So you can think that the importance of this question. So the question is very easy. The only thing is that you have to read out the question and just try to solve the question. Okay, I just want to read because it depends on the basic your if else condition. Means you have to check certain condition on the basis of result. You have to execute two code, means one code when you read the question you will come to know what you are going to do, means but basically I just want to tell you that you have to use if and else condition. Okay, so let me read the question, then only you can understand. Okay, so this thing we have done. Now the question is, write a program in JavaScript to accept a number. Means just stop here, we have to write code in JavaScript. Okay, so no problem, we are learning JavaScript, we can code using JavaScript. Okay, so the thing is that you have to accept a number from user. This line or this sentence is very important because sometimes you miss the question, you could not understand what the examiner try to ask or what the question is actually all about. So the thing is that you have to accept. Sometimes you know the question and sometimes you know the logic, but you use your own variable, your own value. Okay, so in this question you have to accept value from user. Okay, you are not going to hard code the value. Okay, so the thing is that you have to accept value from user and after that and check whether number, means you have to accept a number. Okay, you have to accept a number and you have to check whether accepted number is even or odd. After checking whether if it is even, you have to display proper message. Proper message means what? You have to display that this number is even, or if number is odd, you have to display this number is odd, simply. Okay, so finally we come to know after reading this question, we have to accept a number from user. And after accepting that number, we have to store in certain variable. Then we have to check by using if and else condition. Why I'm going to use if and else condition? Because we have to check, we have to take certain decision. Okay, certain decision means whether its number is even or it is odd. Okay, by putting certain condition, we will come to know whether it's even or it's odd number. So if you are going to check any condition, one thing which should come in your mind, that is if and else condition. Okay, or if and else statement. So we will do the same thing. Before moving toward the question or before solving the question, I just want to tell you a simple thing. I think 99% of the student or 100% of the student might be knowing that what is the even number or what is the odd number. But I have listed some example. These are the some even number. Okay, 2, 4, 6, 8, 10, 14, 16. Then I have given some example of odd number 3, 5, 7, 9, 13, 15, 17. Okay, so these are some example of even. You can check any number. I am not given only up to 24 or 25, but you can check any number whether it's even or not. Means if you are giving a prompt box or an input box to the user, so user can enter any value. Okay, so that value, that number you have to check, you have to validate by using if and else condition. Then you have to display certain message on the basis of your result. If it is even, you have to display number is even, and if it is odd, you have to display number is odd. Okay, again, before starting of this programming, I just want to tell you that we have a logic. Okay, we have a logic. On the basis of that logic, we can verify, we can validate whether number is even or odd. Means we have a logic. I just want to tell you logic. If a number is completely divided by 2. What is mean by completely divided by 2? Okay, what is mean by completely divided by 2? This is the logic I just want to tell you. If a number, if any number completely divided by 2, that number is even number. Simple. For example, if you are going to divide this number 2, if you divide 2, so 2 divided by 2, the remainder will be 0. Okay, if you are going to divide a number by 2 and you will get remainder as 0, that number is even number. What is mean by remainder? Remainder means the remaining value. Means if you are going to divide any number by 2, the number will be completely divided. There is no remainder. For example, if you divide 3 by 2, so 2 ones are 2 and 1 will be remainder. Okay, 1 will be remainder. If you divide 5 by 2, so 2 ones are 2, 2 twos are 4, again 1 will be remainder. Okay, so the thing is that finally we come to know, if you are going to divide any number by 2 and that number is going to completely divide and there is remainder equal to 0, that number is even number. And if remainder is not equal to 0, that number is odd number. Getting? Now we are going moving towards the programming part. We will start our notepad application in which we will write a HTML page. After that we will add our script tag. Inside that we will write JavaScript coding, and inside that we will check, we will accept some value from user and we will apply our logic. After applying, we will check on the basis of the result, we will display message. Okay, so I am moving toward my desktop where I can search notepad application. Okay, this is my notepad application. Okay, I am going to write code inside the HTML and that HTML5. So first thing I will have to doc type HTML, because this line is compulsory if you are going to write code in HTML5. Okay, so this is my opening HTML tag and closing HTML tag. Between these opening and closing tag, we have some another important HTML elements, that is head tag and closing head tag. Then we have main HTML tag, that is a body tag. Whatever you write between these two opening and closing body tag, it will display on your browser. Okay, for example, I am going to write h1 tag, and inside that h1 tag I will have some heading like check even or odd. Okay, so let me show the output. I have written 4-5 line. I just want to, first we have to assign name. I am going to save on my desktop, so you have to assign some name, and name must be saved with .html extension. So you can assign any name. For example, I am going to assign even odd .html. This is the my file name, and .html is extension. Even you can save it .htm. Okay, so now click on save. Now I just want to show the output, what we have just created. This is my even odd file which we have just created. So you will get one heading, that is a h1, check even or odd. This message is coming by using h1. Now I am moving towards JavaScript code. If you want to add JavaScript code, you have to use script tag. Okay, then closing script tag. Student, it is a good practice to open and close both the tag at the same time. Okay, so this is my opening script tag and closing script. Now we have to tell our browser that which scripting language we are using. Okay, so I'm language attribute you have to use inside the script tag, and inside language you have to pass JavaScript. Okay, now student, I have told you n number of the time that this block, this opening and closing script tag, you can add inside the body tag, that is opening and closing body, or even you can put this element, that is opening and closing scripted, between head tag. Okay, so there is no difference between, even you can add inside the head tag or even you can add inside the body tag. Okay, so I have declared a script tag and I have closed the script. Now between opening and closing script tag, whatever you write, it will consider as a JavaScript code. So Again, I am moving back to my question and I will read the first sentence. So this is my question, write a program. So I have started my programming, means I have started scripting. Now it is saying that to accept a number. So the first thing is that I want to accept a number. To, for accepting, I just want to declare a variable called var num. Num means you can declare any variable, where a, where b, where c. It's not compulsory to declare any specific name. You can declare as per your choice. So I am going to declare a variable which name is num. Okay, now inside num I will store some value, num equal to, okay, num is my variable name and I want to store some value, and that value will come from user. So I am going to accept value from user, that is prompt, and inside that I will pass a message that enter any number. So this message will display it to my browser, and it prompt will create a prompt box. Inside that, user read this message and he can enter any value, and that value will store inside variable num. Let me show the thing what is going to happen. Okay, so this is my browser. When I refresh, you will get a prompt box, and you are getting a message, enter any number. So whatever value you will pass inside that text box or input box or prompt box, when you click on OK, that value will be stored inside a variable which you have declared. Okay, so you have declared variable name num. I just want to show the value, how you can display value document dot write, and inside that I am going to pass the variable name. So this line will display the value which is stored inside variable num. Okay student, so it is not required in our question, but I just want to write and I just want to show you that whether you are getting the proper value or not. Okay, so when I refresh it again, it will display a prompt. When I enter 555, that is 555, when I click OK, you will get 555 on your browser. Okay, so you are getting this one. Okay, means you are getting the correct value, but in this case we have to perform certain arithmetic operation. Means you have to, the accepted value you have to check, you have to divide by using 2, and you have to find the remainder. Then you have to compare both the value, whether its remainder is 0 or 1. So you are going to perform certain arithmetic operation. So you need to change or you need to convert your string value, because student we know that by using prompt it will create a prompt box, but the value accepted by the prompt box, it will accepted in the form of a string. Okay, so we have a function called parseInt function. We have seen in number of the time, we are not going to use first time. So parseInt is a function which is used to convert your string into integer. Okay, so let me save it. Now we have checked the value is coming in a good way, so I don't require this line. I have deleted. So this line, from this I just want to explain this line by using this up to selected line prompt enter any value, it will display a prompt box and user will enter any value. Then I have used parseInt function. So parseInt function will convert the accepted value from prompt, it will convert it into integer and it will store inside variable num. So num have certain value which is in integer form. Now I am going to check certain value. So by using if condition, if num mod 2 equal to 0. So I have written a condition. Okay, I have written a condition or decision statement. So when this condition will check, when this expression will execute, two things will happen. Means first thing will be of true. Okay, then second thing will be of false. So two things will be happen. First thing, what will happen? I have written two blog. The this is called true blog, and else this is called the false blog. So this is a condition written. If condition will true, this block will execute. If condition is false, this block will execute. Now I just want to explain what is condition written inside if block. So first I have written num. What is num? Num is a name of variable which stores some value, okay, and the value is coming from your prompt box which is entered by the user. So you have user have entered some value, and that value you have stored inside variable num, and now you are going to check the value by using certain arithmetic operations like mod. Okay, so what is this symbol means? This symbol is called as a mod. Okay, this symbol is called as a mod, where mod means modulus. Mod means modulus. So modulus is used to find the remainder. Modulus symbol is used to find the remainder. Okay, so what could be the remainder? For example, if I write 5 mod 2, if I write 5 mod 2, so the result will be 1. Result will be 1. Why? Because by using this expression, the calculation will be 2 ones are 2, 2 fours are 5. So 4 will be cut, but 1 will be remaining. So the result will be 1. So by using this symbol, mod symbol is used to find the remainder. In the same way, if I write 4 mod 2, so 2 ones are 2, 2 twos are 4. So there is no remainder, means remainder is 0. Okay, remainder is 0. In the same way, if I put 6 mod 2, 2 ones are 2, 2 threes are 6, completely divides. So remainder is 0. If I put 7 mod 2, 2 ones are 2, 2 threes are 6. Okay, 2 threes are 6 means again 7 minus 6 means 1 is remaining, 1 is remainder. Getting my point? So by using this expression, you have written num mod 2 means it will divide your number, your value entered by the user by 2, and it will calculate the remainder. By using this line or this statement, it will find remainder and it will check. For example, I just want to tell you. For example, I just want to explain you. Okay. If num, for example, num equal to user enter num equal to 5. Okay. So num equal to 5. 5 mod 2. Okay, leave this line, okay, 5 mod 2, the output will be 1, yes or no? 5 mod 2, 2 1s are 2, 2 3s are 6, 1 is remaining, so remainder is 1. So after calculation of this expression, you will get remainder, and that remainder will be either 1 or 0. That remainder will be either 1 or 0. So you will get 1 or you will get sometimes 0. Yes or no? For example, currently you are getting 1. If you use, for example, your value is 7, user and 7 mod 2, you will get 1. So 1 equal to 0. Now after calculation of this, you are getting 1 only. Okay, you are getting 1, and now you are going to check 1 equal to 0. What is mean by equal to? This is used for comparison. Okay, this is used for comparison. And if you remember, equal to symbol, this is only equal to, and this is equal to. Okay, so this symbol is used to assigning some value. So here you are going to assign some value to your num variable. So from where you are going to assign? From your prompt parts, prompt box, you are going to assign some value to this variable. But here you are using double equal to or equal equals to. Here you are going to compare the value 1 equal to 0. Means by using this you will get true or false result, whether this condition is true or false. 1 equal to 0, condition is true or false. 1 equal to 0, condition is true or false. Condition is false because 1 is not equal to 0. Are you getting my point? For example, if user enters 6, okay, now 6 more 2, 2 1s are 2, 2 3 are 6, so remainder will be 0. Now if I ask to check this condition, 0 equal to 0, 0 equal to 0, condition is true or false? Condition is true. Condition is true. Are you getting my point? This symbol is called as a comparison operator. So it will compare both the value, and if it will get true result, this block will execute. If it will get false result, this block will execute. Okay, so now we have written two things. One thing is num mode 2, so this will, it will calculate the remainder, and after calculating the remainder, it will check with the value 0. It will compare with the value 0. If remainder is 0, it will say the number is even, and if it is not 0, then the number is odd. Okay, so we are here, we will pass some message. Okay, I will write true condition document dot write. Here I will say number is even. Okay, in the same way, if remainder is not 0, control C, it will come inside the else part, document or number is odd. Okay, let me show the output. Okay, so this is my code, let me open it. Now again it is saying enter any value. I say I have entered 45. Okay, I have entered 45. So when you click OK, so number is odd. Number is odd coming. Why? Because I just want to tell you, because 45 is stored inside variable num, then 45 mode 2. 45 mode 2. What could be the remainder? What could be the result? Because this mode symbol is used to calculate the remainder. So 45 mode 2. So 222s are 44. Yes or no? 222s are 44 and 1 will be remaining. So 1 equal to 0. Okay. 1 equal to 0. Condition is true or false? Condition is false. That's why when condition is false, it will come inside the else part and it will display this block of code. Inside that you have written number is odd. Even let me change this to more proper way. So I will add num plus. So now what you will get? Num plus means, num means the value plus this message. For example, if you currently user have enter 45, so it will say 45 number is even, and or if it is odd, it will display 45 number is odd. Okay, let me show the output again, refresh it. For example, now I am going to enter 13. Okay, so what could be the output if you have entered 13? So 13 will store inside variable num, yes or no? 13 will store, because when user click OK, by using prompt you will receive and you will save inside num. Then you are going to check num. Num is 13. 13 mode 2, remainder will be 1, because 2 1s are 2, 2 6 are 12. 1 will be remainder, because you cannot go 217, 2 7s are 14, it will become more than 1. So you have to divide up to 6, 2 6 are 12. So one is remain, one is remaining, remainder will be one. So one equal to zero, condition is false. So it will not go inside that, it will come inside the else part and it will say document dot write means num, that is 13 number is odd number. Click OK. Sorry. So you are getting 13 number is odd. Okay. Okay, student, understood? Very easy. The first thing is that you have to declare a variable because we need a number to check which number you are going to check. So to store that number, you have declared a variable. Now the number you are not going to hard code. Okay, number you are going to accept from user. So if you want to accept any value from user, you have to use prompt box, okay, or prompt function. But you know, you have to perform certain arithmetic operation, like you are going to perform modulus. Okay, so if you want to perform, as we know, by using prompt box, you can accept value, but that value will be in the form of string. And to string, we cannot perform arithmetic operation. Yes or no? That's why we have to use parseInt function. ParseInt function is used to convert your string value into integer value. So after conversion of this value, we have stored inside the variable num, which we have already declared. Now your value is stored inside variable num, and now you are going to do further thing. What you have to do? You have to check, you have to validate by using certain decision statement. Means by, so you have two option: the number is even or the number is odd. So you have checked, and how you come to know whether number is even or odd? So you have a logic. Means if the number is completely divided by 2 and remainder is 0, so you can say the number is even. And if remainder is not 0 or remainder is 1, you can say number is odd. So that same logic what I am telling you, you have written in certain formulas like num mode 2. Okay, what is num? Num is a name of variable in which you have stored some value. So that value mode 2, so you will get one result, whether you will get 1 or you will get 0. Then this value, this resultant value, you are going to compare by using this compare operator. Okay, so if the condition is true after comparing, means you will get 1. For example, currently you have taken 13, whatever value, if this value will true, you will get inside the this code of line of code. If you will get false result, this line of code will execute. Okay, so this question is very important and the question is very easy. Yes or no? So if you have any question, any query related to if and else condition or related to this question what we have learned, just student, please try to solve, because the question is very easy, but you forget to solve, forget to practice, I think it will become very difficult. Okay, because this is the programming. Okay, by practice you can achieve anything, but if you just read the video, it will do nothing. Okay, that's for today. Keep watching, keep learning. Thank you. Allah Hafiz.